Hey, I'm Paul Begay, AST Systems Designer, and we here at AST are really lucky because we've got Brooklyn St. Michael here from the School of Aquaponics, the Aquaponics God, in New Orleans, looking at what we do here. So if you don't already know about him, check out his YouTube channel, which is called...
The School of Aquaponics.
The School of Aquaponics. Mm-hmm. I just want to ask him a couple questions now that he's here before we end up going inside, taking a look at everything, kind of how he got into it. So, Brooklyn,
yes, sir.
And I have known each other for, I don't know, 4 or 5 months now, right?
Longer than that, Paul. Okay. I think it's about six, seven, 8 months, somewhere around there.
All right. So, I don't think I ever asked you, what got you into aquaponics to begin with?
Aquaponics?
Yeah. Give me the quick and dirty.
Okay, so I was in the Marine Corps, and I had got injured, so I knew I wasn't going to be able to continue in the Marine Corps.
Yeah.
So I was looking for something else to get into,
searching
around, checking around on YouTube, and then boom, I ran across hydroponics first, and I'm like, oh, this is pretty cool.
Yeah.
And then started doing a little bit more research, then came across aquaponics, and
I said,
woo, this is it. I don't want to do nothing else.
Right.
I just want to do aquaponics. I start researching, going crazy.
Right.
Start getting all into it and start building right away, spending all my money on it, and then boom.
Okay. So my next question is this.
Okay, yeah, let's
do it. So you were a DIY kind
all
of guy,
the
right?
DIY.
Do it yourself. Yeah. Until
I start running out of time.
Okay.
And I started figuring out that, hold on, there's another way to do things.
Back to the internet.
Searching, always looking, trying to find out what's new, what else is out there. Because I felt like aquaponics is supposed to be a little bit easier than how it was when I was doing it. Because it was taking up all my time doing maintenance, doing all of that.
And home scale, that's one step, right?
Absolutely.
You start going a little bit more multi-home, small commercial.
Oh yes, absolutely.
That's when you start running into those issues where DIY just isn't going to cut it.
Wasn't going to cut it.
All right. So how'd you find us?
Well,
how'd you find AST?
I found AST because I started figuring out about the filtration as I started doing more feed, and the fish stocking densities begin to increase. I started running into more problems with the filtration.
Right.
And I say, what's going on here?
Right.
I need to find out what the heck is going on out there. So I start researching more and more filters. And then I came across a bead filter. I'm like, what the heck is a bead?
Sure.
I watch hundreds of videos.
What the heck is a bead filter, he asked.
What is a bead filter? I watched hundreds of videos on aquaponics, and I never seen anybody with a bead filter. I'm like, what? It sounds like it works. Let me find out more about it.
Yeah.
So then I said, let me call you guys. That's when I called you.
You called me.
I called you. Oh. We probably talked for maybe about an hour on the phone.
I think it was about an hour. I remember that call, like 59 minutes.
Right.
And I remember at the end of it, I felt real good about it because, one, you ended up buying an endurance filter or a bubble
bead. It was a bubble wash bead filter.
That was
the first one I bought.
And I remember thinking, all right, this is the kind of guy that we want to do business with.
Mm-hmm.
He's a passionate guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started looking at your YouTube stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then I said, you know what? I'm doing my own YouTube stuff too.
Yeah.
And then you remember the call? I called you up and I said, how's my YouTube?
Right.
And I remember your answer was good. You said, it was a long pause, and he said, decent.
Yeah.
And so I did some upgrades
to it.
We did some upgrades.
Right.
And we're doing pretty good right now.
Yep.
So, with that, what we're going to do now is we're going to bring Brooklyn inside, and then we're going to have him look at the systems, look at the filters, and make sure that our viewers meet him and that his viewers are able to see what the filters do in action.
I'm not finished yet, Paul. Hold on.
All right,
talking about the bead filter
right now.
Listen. I'm going to tell you guys when I got the bead filter.
All right.
I didn't tell you guys. Hold on. I was first using like the old DIY radio flow filters, swirl separators.
Coming into,
I had some bird netting that I was using, and I'll have to go out there cleaning it every single day, cleaning it off with a pressure washer.
Yeah.
And then my life changed. when I got to be stuck. Oh my goodness. And I have been, I'm almost like a someone who's going around preaching. I'm knocking on doors. You need a bead filter. Everybody, you need a bead filter. You need a bead filter. For doing aquaponics, you need a bead filter. Listen, right. I'm just coming in there, turning switches, turning knobs, and I'm out of there.
That's right.
And
that's
I'm out of there. Yeah. And it saved me a tremendous amount of time, and I can never go back.
All right.
With that, we can go and do our tours.
All right, my man. Let's do it. Okay. Stay tuned for more videos with School of Aquaponics and the aquaponics god, Brooklyn St. Michael. Woo. Thanks so much.